everyone, and welcome to another tutorial. Today I'm going to give you a little introduction into Adobe Ideas. It's a vector drawing application created by Adobe. And what we're going to do is I'm going to show you a little bit of the interface and how you can use it and how you can take some of these illustrations into Illustrator or Photoshop if you want to do any more fine tuning or anything like that to your illustrations. So when you launch Adobe Ideas, you'll see here that if you have some illustrations in the work, as I do, you see a big selection that you can scroll through. On the very top right, you can actually select the illustration and duplicate it, which is handy in case you want to save multiple versions or if you want to adjust one without affecting a different one or something like that. You can also select and trash an idea if you don't want it anymore. And the button to the right of that is the settings button. At the very bottom, you'll see there's a little plus, and what we can do is we can actually create a new idea or a new illustration, but this will be just a blank canvas to work on. The button next to it will allow you to actually select a photograph that you have on your device, and you can use that for reference. Now, in Adobe Ideas, you're allotted about one photo layer to work with for reference. So if you need to use a second photo, what you'll probably have to do is delete the other one and just import another one into that photo layer and move it around to it fits the right scale or position. And if you have to go back to the other one, you just have to re-import it over and over again because there's only one photo layer, but you get about at least 10 layers of drawing layers, which is in this app, it's the most important layers of all. So let's go ahead and take a look at this illustration I've been working on. It's the Bizarro character here. And you can see up at the very top, here's my name, and I can basically select this and I can rename my illustration anything I want, which is handy for organizing any of your illustrations. To the right, you can see we can email this as a vector PDF or save it as an image to our device. And a little icon there kind of hides all the tools. So to the left, we have our eraser, our pen, we have our hand icon, which will help move the canvas around as a whole. Or if you select the little navigator here, you can actually just scale and move just a certain layer. As you notice, this illustration was on a different layer than the ink. And now we have our undo and redo buttons below that. And right below that, you can see the size of our pen brush. So let me go ahead and switch back to the brush tool, and I can adjust the size of how thick or thin I want the sketch to be, and the opacity. So let's say I want to doodle maybe something this color, and then I want to just go ahead and take the opacity down. And look, now I can make it more of a fainter color or transparent or something like that. And we'll go ahead and undo that. And let's go ahead and bring the opacity back up. If I select the colors, you see it brings up this little theme picker, and I can actually choose to use the HSB to find new colors, or I can use RGB sliders, or I can go into the themes tab, and as you can see, I've created a ton of custom color themes that I like to use. And you can pick any of these color themes and just click and drag and drop them on top of the old one, just like that, and now you can use those colors to quickly pick new colors to help paint in any of your illustrations. So this is really handy, and you can create new ones in Adobe Ideas as well. So let's go ahead and drag that. Let's just take this pencil tool, and let's select a new color. And here's, you can see our layers palette. I just have like a outline and my inked in shadow filled in layer. You can see you can control the opacity. You can see the one photo layer at the bottom. I can create a new layer, drag it to the bottom, and color this one in. And because the top layer is transparent, you can see it just fills in and the lines overlap on top of the color. Now you notice how I scaled and zoomed in really close. You notice how crisp and clean those lines were. Basically, that shows you that this is a vector image, and no matter how far you zoom into it, it's going to be sharp and clear no matter what. All right, so there we go. We have our little sketch, and if we want to, when we're done with it, we can go ahead and email it to ourselves. So I'm going to show you how you can take this into Illustrator and further make any kind of adjustments. All right, so now we're in Illustrator, and now you can see here's my illustration imported right from Adobe Ideas into Illustrator. And you can see it broke down all the little layers I had in my Illustrator Adobe Ideas file. And if I mouse over, you can see that all those little brush strokes are actually still editable. I can change the fill, the color, I can change the waypoints or the little pathfinder points and add more and change any size of anything else. So I can take this illustration, continue cleaning it up, and add any special effects to I want it that I want to in Illustrator. And that's it. That's a little quick introduction to Adobe Ideas. I hope you enjoyed it. Hope you try this app out. It's a lot of fun. I know I have a lot of fun using it. And yeah, if you have any questions, feel free to email me and have a great day.